mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
The 22nd day of January, 2014. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We'll be here for the next 3 hours. And we'll have open phones in the first and second hour on any subject you wish to discuss. And, of course, interspersed with a ton of vital news and information on the economy, the world, the ongoing move towards the singularity that is taking place. That is all coming up here today. The giant cold front with the Arctic vortex of global warming descending upon us. If we would have paid Al Gore money, he would have saved us from all this global warming. Of course, we did pay him carbon taxes and did pay the Clintons carbon taxes and did pay the Rothschilds carbon taxes. But you notice that it's still the global warming is annihilating us right now because if we would have paid more indulgences, they could have waved a magic wand and made the sun not to go into a cooling cycle as it has now causing the global warming. Of course, you'd think the sun cooling and putting off less heat radiation would actually make the Earth get colder, which it is getting colder, but that's actually realities. But I need to be politically correct, and I need to be honest with everybody and just say that we're weathering some of the worst heat waves the world's ever seen right now. And, you know, it's no longer global warming anyways. It's climate change. And so if the weather ever changes, well, the answer, again, is to pay the government more money and pay private interest more money, and then that will fix it. Because really it's about having guilt, feeling like you're guilty so they can run your life. You know, I've talked a lot about dehumanization the last few days, especially on yesterday's broadcast, which is the 41st anniversary of 55 million dead babies just here in America. I wonder what the estimated total of worldwide abortions have been the last 50 years. You guys look up the estimate on worldwide, because this is actual humans being killed. They just have estimates. It's not very important. You know, they can tell you exactly how many bits of information you transferred over your computer or over your smartphone the last 3 years, but and they can tell you how many bombs the Army produced, and they can tell you, you know, basically what your insurance actuary was in 1942, but they cannot tell you how many abortions there has been. Earth Day, abortion has killed 1-2 billion people worldwide in 50 years. What does that mean, 1-2 billion people? Exactly. Just no one knows exactly. It's like a billion or two, give or take. It was Stalin that said, one man dies, it's a tragedy, 10,000 die, it is a statistic. And that is certainly the truth. We're going to go to break here. We have this little first segment, and then I'm going to come back and hit some of the top stories and then throw the phone numbers out. But I do want to hear from callers. You can call in about whatever you want, but I'd really like to hear from callers. I'll try to go to you as quickly as possible. That probably means I'll go to you very, very slowly. But I'd like to hear from callers out there dealing with the situation of the culture of death and your view on abortion and where you think it's going. And if we just bypass the debate about it being a woman's right and just point out that the eugenicist and the Rockefeller Foundation got it legalized. They push it. I mean, Bill Gates is in the news, you know, saying government spying isn't always bad. This is from one of the biggest spies out there. And then we've got the fact that he's funding a better, thinner condom. And by the way, I'm not against birth control if it's your choice. The problem is they usually piggyback in the birth control something very damaging to the woman or the man. And it's just part of a larger depopulation agenda. So we should have a discussion about that today as well. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com. The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalists by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com. Why does the United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare? Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the planet? The highest rates of diabetes, autism, and every other major disease? It all comes down to one thing. We are what we eat. Our food is devoid of nutrition and processed with poisons and additives. Our water is filled with toxic poisons and big pharma runoff. All of this has been engineered by design. We can turn the tide against the eugenicist by giving ourselves the nutrients our body desperately needs. To learn more, visit InfoWarsHealth.com. The site is literally packed with audio and video featuring top health professionals who don't bow down to big pharma. The fight against the New World Order starts with you, and you can't stand against the machine of your sick, tired, and obese. When you visit InfoWarsHealth.com, be sure and check out the catalog with nearly 400 life-changing products and get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip.
You are listening to an InfoWars.com frontline report. It's Alex Jones.
Waging war on corruption, crashing through the lies and disinformation. Thank you for joining us on this worldwide live original Wednesday edition, already the 22nd day of 2014. Coming up for about 30 minutes in the third hour, Adam Kokesh, who was recently sentenced to probation for daring to load a shotgun inside the District of Columbia as a political protest, will be joining us to talk about that and a lot more. It's been a while since he was on with us, and I was in contact with him when he was in jail. And now he can basically tell all about how he was set up on the drug charges, all of it. He's a very honest guy about smoking marijuana, but he says he was set up with the mushrooms. They were trying to get him with a felony. And the witnesses that were there said the police walked in with all these big bags they had with them, federal police. They sent the Park Service to his house for saying that he'd committed the crime of racking a shotgun in a square that was controlled by a Park Service. So it's just, imagine now, you know, the Park Service comes to your house and then comes into it with a SWAT team and then did stuff like kick Kokesh while he was in handcuffs sitting in the bathroom, and witnesses saw that. Imagine just kicking someone for no reason in the belly because they dare engage in political protest for the Second Amendment. I mean, yeah, I mean, I'd be, I mean, I'll be honest with you. If I was a cop and I had, say, busted a child pornographer that had been abusing children, I would want to beat their brains out. The problem is, A, you can't turn into what you're fighting. B, they'll end up getting off if you beat them up. So you want to make sure that you don't do that, obviously. But that's not what they did. Dishonorably kicking somebody in the stomach when they're in handcuffs for no reason. It's the height of cowardly activity. And I'm not lionizing Kokesh, but here's somebody who is a Marine in Fallujah, comes back, is anti-war, has a lot of political courage, gets a little wild at times, you know, might have PTSD, who knows. But the point is that at least he's not a coward. And people can sit there and Monday morning, Tuesday morning, quarterback all day long. Are you racking shotguns in D.C.? And doing it to point out that for 5 years they violated the Supreme Court ruling that they have to let people be armed, specifically in that case with a shotgun. D.C. Heller versus D.C. or D.C. versus Heller. What was the Heller case? It was an off-duty cop couldn't have a shotgun at his house. I mean, just give me a break, folks. Just give me a break. That's like seeing Rosa Parks. Aha, she should have sat at the back of the bus. It's so easy to say people should do things and get involved and take action. But then when they do, everybody sits there and second guesses them. And I really think when somebody's in the arena and they're trying to do the right thing, it's easy to sit back and say, hey, they should do better here, they should do better there. But what matters is who is in the arena. And it doesn't matter if their face is marred and they're sweating and they're bleeding. They know the animating contest of liberty, and they're not the timid people that are sitting up in the bleachers that are just imagining in their minds that they could do a better job. Well, some of you probably could do a better job. Why don't you come get on the field? And I was paraphrasing Teddy Roosevelt. You guys pull up Teddy Roosevelt quote in the arena. Put that on screen for me, thank you. And I will read that on air because I think that's really what it all comes down to. There is so much to cover today, obviously. Romanian police claim they've caught Guccifer. I've actually had national media call me and call people I know repeatedly trying to find out if we were Guccifer. And Gucciardi's been called by press and they ask questions about Guccifer. And I guess that's because there's some reference before Guccifer showed up. We were talking about Dusifer in some text articles that were up mentioning Rob Dew. It was some transcript of a show online talking about Rob Dew that some of the crew used to call Dusifer because he'd get mad if they didn't do stuff. And so the media thought that like maybe we were Guccifer. Listen, I wish I was Guccifer. I wish I was good at all this tech stuff, believe me. But they're claiming that, again, there's just so much crazy stuff going on right now. Wall Street Advisor says actual unemployment is actually 37.2. I agree with those numbers. Record 20% of households on food stamps. We've got really some huge news that I'm going to get to here in just a moment that is really earth-shaking in its import for humanity and ties into abortion, ties into the whole culture of death, ties into this entire larger system. And then we're also going to get into former Virginia Governor McDonald, wife indicted on federal corruption charges. So he and his wife have been indicted on that. And of course, he's a Republican. And of course, it is a federal indictment. And it's the chef in there, money on it, a Democrat. And here's my issue. I'm nonpartisan when it comes down to what politicians really do, and I go after them. And when Karl Rove went after, what was the governor of Alabama, and clearly set him up on stuff that wasn't corruption by any benchmark, I spoke out against that. Because clearly he was being railroaded. Even more clearly than this case. This has a lot of evidence of baseline standard corruption, standard fraud. That's how it works. People give you gifts.